So I've been at Venmo for 2 years, and for the first 22 months at Venmo, I was on the iOS team, and I built a large part of the app that exists currently today. And now I'm on the strategy team, where I focus on exploring different monetization strategies at Venmo. The Venmo iOS team decided to rewrite the Venmo app in Swift around the same time as WWDC 2015. Swift 2 was just announced, and we were watching all of these videos about all the cool things you can do with Swift. At the same time, coincidentally, our product and design teams were discussing new UIs and new UXs in the Venmo app. Also at the same time, our existing Objective-C codebase was becoming very unmaintainable. Building new features was taking a long time. And if we ever wanted to do any design changes to the app or different flows in the app, it would require massive refactors because of the fact that our UI layers and our model layers were so deeply coupled together. So one day after one of the WWDC sessions, all of us came back to the San Francisco office and just started whiteboarding what a Swift version of the Venmo app would look like. We made an API layer, we made a UI layer, and we just then opened up our computers and started building it. This wasn't an official project or anything, but we kept doing this for about a week and a half and came up with a bare bones version of the Venmo app. Kind of just experiment and see how a Swift only version of the Venmo app feels and how much faster we think we can iterate on a version like this as opposed to the current Objective-C app. We got to a very good point in those 2 weeks and finally told product about what we're working on and how this is a code base that's going to be maintainable for a very long time. And it's also going to enable us to write features much faster. And because of all that, they decided to get on board, and we started building this app. Objective-C will stick around for a very, very, very long time. All of UIKit, Foundation, and I think all of Apple's frameworks are actually written in 100% Objective-C. I don't think Objective-C is going to go anywhere for an extremely long time. And I think that having some knowledge about how it works is extremely important. I do think that as time goes on, more and more Objective-C developers will be writing Swift more and more often. A lot of existing companies that have 100% Objective-C apps will start catching the Swift train and start building all of their new features in Swift, which I highly recommend. What I don't recommend is just rewriting an app, a perfectly good app in Objective-C into Swift, because it's going to be a very, very, very long project with very little gain. Well, one of the largest challenge of doing a big rewrite is the fact that during that time of the rewrite, your team can't really build new product features. And if you are building new product features, you have to build it twice, once in the existing app as well as in the new app. The nice thing is that when you build it twice, you can actually see how much faster you're building it in the new app, which is quite delightful and it kind of proves your point to the rest of the team that this is a good decision. But that was definitely the most difficult part about doing this rewrite, that when we were being conservative on new features in the Venmo app during this time, and that the ones that absolutely had to get in had to be written multiple times. We're still working on it today. It's almost done. The scope of the app has also changed a lot since we first started. That said, the entire team's working on it. And whenever some project does come up, like a product feature that needs to come out does come up, one of us will move off the core app, rewrite app, and start working on that project, and then work on it twice, once for the old app and once for the new app. If we were hiring a new developer at Venmo who would primarily be writing Swift, I think that them having some Objective-C knowledge coming in to Venmo would be really valuable to us. And it would also differentiate them from other candidates that might only know Swift, which is really important. Though our entire code base will be 100% Swift, we do have a lot of dependencies that are Objective-C, and sometimes you do have to go into them and maintain them. We would want them to know the syntax of Objective-C primarily, as well as some of the nuances of Objective-C. For example, Objective-C variables are by default always optional. That means that it opens you up to a lot of errors and runtime bugs, which you don't have in Swift. And so it's important to be even more careful and check for nil before you're adding a variable into a dictionary. A lot of our third-party dependencies are still in Objective-C, some of which we've open sourced ourselves. So going back into those dependencies and updating things is like important. So knowing basic Objective-C syntax is very important. Knowing how to do a nullability audit to make sure that like your Swift code plays nice with Objective-C is also very important.